Hi, this is a little demo of the Agora application, which is intended to be an event display of for the ATLAS experiment, and in particular an event display which is able to run on smartphone and tablet. Here I am going to show the Cocoa version that run on my Mac, and the layout of everything is going to be exactly the same on all platforms. Then what we can do is to show, for example, a piece of detector. You have to remember, mainly in all my apps, then there is two mode. One is the viewing mode, and the other one is the GUI mode, and you pass from one to the other by clicking at the bottom of the window and by touching the bottom of the window on smartphone and tablet. Okay. Then here I can map some camera dedicated buttons to zoom, move in 3D, reset, to turn 19 degrees. I can load another piece of detector. What I can do is load an event file and start to display some data per event here. Today I can only view the jet in the event. And the jet as a result of what happened in a collision at the vertex of two protons. Then I'm going to open a file that comes with the distribution. It's a JIV event file. The JIV, then we see here the jets. I'm going to remove. I have a pop-up menu in the back here. From here I can remove, for example, what is detector, and only reload one. I'm going to reload this one that do not hide, that does not hide the vertex. And these here tracks are as a result of the collision of proton here at the vertex. That produces some secondary particles that are grouped together in jets. And with that, HEP physicists are able more or less to guess what happened here at the vertex. And in principle, this one shows is more or less the signature of the production of a Higgs event. For files here, the files are the XML format produced by the ATLAS Athena framework, which are some XML at the JIV XML format that has been designed to produce files for event display, in particular for the moment for the Atlantis event display, which is written in Java. And as these files are quite easy to parse, then we have started to modify our first version of the Agora application to read this file. You can get more files here. You can declare some FTP in your website. And here I'm going to get data in my lab. Here I have other file, I can choose this one. Another event. When you have a view that you like in the application, you have some an export mode that permits to produce a PNG or a JPEG file, which is put in the document directory of the application. On a Mac, it is under Documents, Agora. And on a smartphone or tablet, on iOS or Android, you have here an extra mail push button that permits to send the JPEG or PNG in attachment to by email. And on iOS and Android, you have the JIV extension, file extension has been declared. And in principle, you can, for example, on iOS, open from a file that comes as an attachment by email, you can open with or open in Agora. Mainly, the open in menu of mail should show you the Agora as a viewer for this kind of file. Okay. Else you have kind of some predefined camera position. Well, today there is not so much in the application. But we hope, since now we are able to parse this GIV file, to show more of what happened in the detector in some further release. What else? Yes, you have another kind of file, another one that come with the distribution, something that we had in the first version, which is some tuple at the root format that has been designed to produce some data coming from ATLAS. Then if I choose that, and in this kind of DST file, I have multiple events in them, then when a file is open, I can click on this button here to show the events. And on this particular kind of file, I have some animation and loop on events, which permit to show, to test a little bit the speed of navigation in a root file here containing some event, especially on tablet and smartphone, and we can show that we can really navigate easily. We have the speed to do that, even on a smartphone today. And well, that's all for the demo, since right now there's not so much in Agora. Then I'm going to quit nicely here. The exit button, you don't have it on phone and tablet. You have to use the home button on iOS and the stop button on an Android device. That's all. Bye.